Hi guys, welcome to another recipe video. Before I begin, I would like to remind you to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so already. I would really appreciate it. Today I'm gonna share with you how I make jackfruit carne con chile colorado. This is a Mexican style stewed chili and it's really savory and bright red, so you know it's gonna be super tasty. You can enjoy this meal with a side of rice and beans and tortillas, of course. Or my favorite way, you can make taquitos out of this meat and it is so good. So if you're interested, let's begin. For this vegan recipe, I'm substituting the traditional beef or pork meat for jackfruit. Since the jackfruit came in a can, I'm gonna rinse it a few times and then leave it soaking in a bowl with water, and then I'm gonna rinse it again a few more times to get rid of that brine taste that I really don't like, but it's all worth it though. Also, in the meantime, I'm gonna show you the guajillo peppers, which are the ones to your left. These dried peppers are very mild in spice and add a beautiful red color to food. The first thing you need to do is to devein them and deseed them. I've also removed the stem and they should look something like this. Also, the two little chilies on the right hand side, those are chiles de arbol. They are optional because they're spicy. So if you'd like your dish to have a spicy kick, you can add them. All you need to do is remove the stem for those. The first step is to hydrate them. You want to simmer water, leave it on a very low flame. Then you want to add the dried chili peppers into the hot water and allow them to hang out there for about 10 minutes until they are soft and tender. And then you want to toss the water. And what I'm going to do now is transfer my chilies into my blender. I'm also going to add a wedge of onion, garlic cloves, ground cumin, black pepper, oregano, vegan bouillon, and as you guys know, I love vegan bouillon because anytime you're trying to imitate the taste of meat, vegan bouillon is what's gonna make your food taste amazing. So I recommend this. Also, you wanna add water and you wanna blend until it is nice and smooth, just like this. Now that the sauce is ready, the next step is to heat up a large skillet. My flame is on a medium high. I added the jackfruit without oil or seasonings. I'm not doing that yet. At this point, I'm just browning it a little bit. Then I'm gonna add chopped onion for added flavor and texture, followed by vegan bouillon. I'm adding a little bit more. As I mentioned earlier, anytime a dish is supposed to mimic the taste of meat, I love to add vegan bouillon. It makes it taste amazing. So what I'm gonna do is just mix everything well. And as you can see, it's still browning. Now I'm going to add a little bit of all-purpose flour. The reason for this is to thicken the red sauce once we add it. The sauce is pretty runny and this is a stew, so the flour is gonna help thicken it up a little bit more. But before I do that, I'm gonna add some oil over the jackfruit because regular animal meat is usually greasy and I feel like that's where the flavor comes from. So I'm adding oil over the jackfruit to add more flavor. And I'm gonna mix everything up. And as you can see, it looks really nice. It's nice and brown. You could actually kind of eat it like this. It almost resembles carnitas, but I'm not doing that. I'm actually gonna add the red sauce and I am just gonna pour it over, mix it in well, and then I'm gonna lower the flame to a low medium and we're just gonna kind of let it simmer. And while that is simmering, I did cube up boiled potatoes. This is optional, but I love potatoes in this recipe. It is so good. I should mention that if you don't want to add potatoes to this dish, but instead would much rather have a meatier chile colorado, you can definitely do that. I added one can of jackfruit to this recipe, but if you want yours meatier, you can add two cans of jackfruit. All you would have to do is adjust the seasonings like the bouillon and maybe add more oil, but overall it would be the same thing. You would cook it the exact same way, but I will have the details in the description box below where you could find this recipe. This has been simmering for about 30 minutes. This is now the perfect time to add my cubed potatoes. I'm going to carefully mix them in and incorporate them with the jackfruit and the sauce. And really, this is looking so mouthwatering to me right about now. But yes, I'm just gonna allow for them to cook for a few more minutes and then I'm gonna turn off the flame. The flavors have now intensified. This dish is ready to serve. Here is my jackfruit carne con chile colorado. Just look at this color. It is so amazing. You can seriously enjoy this by itself or with the side of rice and beans and warm tortillas. Or you can make these amazing taquitos. They are so good. I mean, you guys saw this stew was simmering for over 30 minutes. So it is full of flavor. So all you have to do if you want to make the taquitos is warm up some tortillas. Then you want to scoop a little bit of the carne colorado mixture in there. And then all you do is roll it into a tight little taquito shape. Then heat up a hot nonstick pan, add some oil, and fry the taquitos on both sides until they are golden brown and they look something like this. And just like that, you've made your very own taquitos. You can add your favorite toppings like vegan sour cream, lettuce, guacamole, whichever way you enjoy them. I'm sure you're gonna love them. And really, I wanna thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed this recipe of my vegan carne colorado. And honestly, it's so good and super simple and hearty. And so I hope you try it. As always, I wanna thank you so much for watching. I really appreciate it. I will see you guys soon in the next video. Take care.